Hey, it's Jimmy Otto, and I am here at the iconic grounds of Mount Loretto. Speaking of iconic, I'm with another legend, my buddy from the city council days.
You usually mean old, doesn't it?
Yes, you are old. Who runs Catholic Charity Staten Island, and we are standing in the church that famously was part of The Godfather, the film on the steps outside. And we're here to talk about the fact that Hollywood has rediscovered Mount Loretto in no small part thanks to Jen San Martino and our team and the Made On Staten Island initiative that we started when we got to Borough Hall. But in all seriousness, Vinny, if we could be serious for a moment.
Sure.
This is a really good thing for Catholic Charities in addition to being a really good thing for Staten Island. Tell us what's happening on the campus.
Sure. Just in the past month, we've had four major productions right here, from Wu-Tang to Blacklist to American Saga. Universal Studios is coming. We're talking to Billions, which I really want to see because I love Billions. This is all part and parcel of what your office has been doing with Jen to try to get people out here. We had the Commissioner of Film out here with your staff to say, hey, take a look. We have unique situations here for filming right here in Mount Loretto. We have our own road system. We have these unique type of buildings, you know, things that we could use, a church, because it's not used every day. What they're looking for in Hollywood, and what they say to me often, is things that look old period pieces or that we can make something. There's plenty to do here. It's a 170-acre campus, and all the money that we get goes right back into the charity to help development disabled, to put on our festivals, that do nice things for the community. So they're here, they're making money, they're spending money and catering and everything else, and it also goes back to the community in the form of improvements here for Mount Loretto.
We got to Borough Hall in January in 2014, and one of the first things we said we were going to do is try to grab for Staten Island a larger slice of that television and film pie. And the numbers from 2014 to now, and Jen's gonna go over some of those numbers, demonstrate the success. So it's happening here on the grounds and the campus of Mount Loretto, but it's also happening across Staten Island, because if you have a particular backdrop, whether it's urban, suburban, the woods, old buildings, water, you name it, you want a place that looks like Milwaukee, you want a place that looks like whatever, we have it. And Jennifer has done a fabulous job in getting Staten Island into the consciousness of Hollywood, and I want Jen to talk about what she's done on Made on Staten Island.
So back in 2013, we were probably looking at 50 or 60 productions a year coming to Staten Island. Now we're up at 90 productions a year. And that's 90 productions. That's not how many permits were filed. That's not how many scenes they filmed here. That's 90 different shows or movies that we're filming here on Staten Island. Mount Loretto is one of the best examples of what we have to offer here for Hollywood in terms of what's on Staten Island. We can double for so many different backgrounds. This campus has been in crime shows that were set in the 1950s and the 1960s. Snug Harbor has actually been a Hawaiian naval base. I mean, there's no end to the creativity of Hollywood, and they're able to do all these things on Staten Island. And I think that one of the reasons it works so well is because we have so many willing partners, like Catholic Charities, like Snug Harbor, like Historic Richmond Town, like private homeowners who are really willing to do this, and communities coming together to make these things work. So how can you get involved? If you own a home, you can certainly put that home up that you are film friendly. You can go to our website, statenislandusa.com/madeonsi, and you will see an area where you can contact me, Jennifer San Martino, via email. Send me some photos and a description of your home and the best contact information to reach you. I will tell you that what film industry is looking for are, believe it or not, things that are dated. So if your house is perfectly preserved from 1950, 1960, 1970, 1980, in the 90s, they want to talk to you. These are the kind of things they're looking for. They're also looking for attics. They're looking for tunnels. They're looking for things that are sort of dark and creepy. Closets. These are the kind of requests that we get. So that if those are things that you have on your property that you would be willing to have the film industry come in and make a movie, make a commercial, make a TV show, they would want to talk to you about that, and we're happy to facilitate that conversation. If you're interested in filming with your property, or your business does catering, or your business does cleaning, any number of things, we can help you facilitate that relationship with the film industry. So please visit statenislandusa.com/madeonsi.
And I think Jen touched on what is a really important point, and that is that this is about helping entities like Catholic charities, but this is a version of economic development. And the synergy between growing this industry on Staten Island and Broadway Stages, which is going to come online in full capacity in the coming years, is obvious and it's real, and we want to continue to grow it.
One of the good things we have here in a lot of places on Staten Island in general is we also have holding areas. We have places, because we have so much space, we have places for the trucks. We have places for people to wait. We have places for people to eat. We have large bathroom facilities. These are all the things that Staten Island has because we have much more land than they do, say, in Manhattan. So it makes it easier for film locations to come here and to utilize our space. Just last week, we had Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. Am I saying that right? They were filming actually across the street, and they used our area for trucks and for food services and for holdover. And that's great for us, and it was great for the Department of Environmental Conservation, where they filmed for. So we're open for business. Come and talk to us, and we want to see your film be shot here.
The only criticism, the only downside is I have yet to get a movie part, and I keep getting typecast as the angry middle-aged dude. I don't understand why that is!
Nor do I.